We begin the day in the town of Trois-Îlets at one of Martinique's trendiest boutique hotels. The five-star La Suite Villa has an outsized personality and a view to match. Take your pick, the infinity pool or the view from your room. A taste of Martinican luxe life before we hit the road and head north. Just across the road from this beach in Ante Ceyron is Habitation Ceyron. Built in 1658 as a sugarcane plantation, today many of these 185 acres are an ecotourism site.
I like to share this, so I love that all the world could come and see it.
Originally from the south of France, Laurence Marot de Grotte and her family took over Habitation Ceyron 25 years ago, long after it had been abandoned. The property backs up onto a biological reserve that's home to a natural wonder.
This is the Zamana tree, the most famous tree in all of the Caribbean.
It's so big and it's like the image of a small paradise. It's just beautiful.
A mimosa tree, Zamana, is the largest tree on record in the Lesser Antilles. It's more than 300 years old, with foliage spanning 2.5 acres.
It was introduced in Martinique to grow the cocoa and the coffee trees, because it lives just close under the rain, right? And when the sun is shining, they open again. So it maintains humidity on the floor, which is excellent for growing cocoa and coffee.
In 2016, Zamana was voted France's best tree in a competition organized by the National Forest Office.
You have the Tour Eiffel in Paris, you have lots of things, but the nicest tree of France is in Martinique.
Also at Habitation Ceyron, an active cocoa farm, and Marot de Grotte is carefully preserving the ruins here.
You can see all the sugarcane factory, from the mill down to the fireplace.
And how long was this an active plantation?
The activity stopped in the middle of the 18th century.
At the plantation's peak, 250 slaves toiled at the sugar mill. That's important history, says Marot de Grotte.
It should not disappear, and it should be open to the public to be visited.
Back in Trois-Îlets, up a dirt road, another historic site. Since 1783, the Pottery Village has sold arts and crafts, mostly red clay pottery and other local goods.
This is Martinique's famous Madras fabric. Look at this.
Steps away from the shops, Au Coup de Coeur, a renowned French bakery. Every day, Chef Valerie Onfroy crafts these beloved sweets. Our guide Geraldine introduces us to a special treat today.
We are here to share la galette des rois,
a cake made with sweet almonds.
This one is particular. It's more authentic. It's made with coconut and sweet potatoes. If you're lucky enough to find the fève inside the galette, you will become the queen.
The queen?
Yeah.
The queen.
The fève is a tiny favor hidden inside the galette.
I hope I get the fève. Is it a fève?
Fève.
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 I hope I get the fève.
I'm sure you will get the fève.
Looks like Chef Valerie is rigging the game because voila!
Et voici la reine.
Yeah. Ah, the queen!
On the road again, all signs point to beachside restaurant Le Petit Bonhomme.
Finiment mitote, c'est chaud comme toi.
Owner Guy Ferdinand is famously known as, get this, Chef Hot Pants.
It's very well known in Martinique, but I think all over the world too. This is the local cuisine, but the new way to do it, you know, and stay very close to our tradition.
But first, why the nickname?
Always I've short because I'm working on the beach, so it's better for me. I think my legs are really good, but my kitchen also.
In his kitchen, Chef Hot Pants prepares his take on Martinican cuisine, a blend of French and Creole.
Every day we create a starter, a plate, and a dessert. I think if you want to taste something, you can do it just for you, because your pleasure is our pleasure.
Today, it's fritters, cod and bilao, a local fish, followed by Creole risotto with crawfish and sweet potatoes.
Each night I dream and I wake up with a dream and I try to make my dream on my plate.
Love him. Back to the top of the segment, the hotel, La Suite Villa. Kind of famous for its night scene as well, which is nice.
Yeah, a lot of top acclaimed chefs come there. Or they're in the kitchen, and when they come, let me tell you, the place is packed. It's a lot of fun. Another place that's very busy, Habitation Ceylon, where you saw the plantation. They have over 60 acres of cocoa plants on the property, which is amazing. And a local manufacturer actually takes the beans and turns them into gourmet chocolate. And I had some. It was unbelievable. Melts in your mouth.
Well, you had the chocolate, but also on Martinique, a banana a day keeps the doctor away. Bananas, rum, and a lonely coffee plant.